Good morning. The lecture topic, glycolytic paths of respiration. Lecture plan. First, anaerobic phase of respiration, glycolysis. Second, the aerobic phase of respiration. Third, the tricarboxylic acid cycle, Krebs cycle. Aerobic phase of respiration. The second phase of respiration, aerobic, is localized in the mitochondria and requires the presence of oxygen. Pyruvic acid enters the aerobic phase of respiration. The general equation of this process is as follows. The process can be divided into three main stages: oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvic acid, conversion of pyruvate and fatty acid received from the cytoplasm into mitochondria into acetyl-CoA, the oxidative of acetyl-CoA in the tricarboxylic acid cycle, Krebs cycle, the final stage of oxidation. The electron transport chain requires the obligatory presence of oxygen. Electron transfer from NADH to oxygen through the respiratory chain. The formation of ATP as a result of the activity of the membrane ATP synthase complex. The first two stages occur in the matrix of mitochondria. The electron transport chain is localized on the inner membrane of mitochondria. The first stage, oxidative decarboxylation. Under aerobic condition, pyruvate by a sphincter with H ions moving along the proton gradient penetrates the mitochondria. Here it is converted to acetic acid, which is transported by coenzyme A. The total equation reflects the oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvate, the reduction of NAD to NADH, and the formation of acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA is formed during the breakdown of sugars, fatty acids, and certain amino acids and is used in the synthesis. It's a reactive carrier of an acetyl group. In some reaction, it is used for the synthesis of organic substance, in other for their burning as fuel. Therefore, acetyl-CoA is an important mediator in many biochemical processes associated with the exchange of matter and energy. A carbon dioxide molecule is split off from the pyruvate molecule and the remaining acetyl group is attached to coenzyme A. With the formation of acetyl-CoA form an NADH and carbon dioxide. Tricarboxylic acid cycle. The cycle persists in the mitochondrial matrix and represents 8 consecutive reactions. First, the cycle begins with the interaction of acetyl-CoA molecule with the oxaloacetic acid, resulting in the formation of 6 carbon tricarboxylic acid called citric acid, while CoA is released in its previous form. This process is catalyzed by the enzyme citrate synthase. Citric acid is converted to isolimonic. The conversion of citrate to isocitrate is catalyzed by isocitrate containing iron in divalent state. This reaction is carried out in two stages. First, dehydration occurs with the formation of cis isocitrate and then hydration and the formation of isocitrate. The next step is the oxidation of isolimonic acid. The reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme isocitrate dehydrogenase. In this case, protons and electrons are transferred to NADH. This reaction requires magnesium or manganese ions. At the same time, the process of decarboxylation occurs due to one of the carbon atoms that entered the Krebs cycle. The first carbon dioxide molecule is released. The resulting alpha-ketoglutaric acid undergoes oxidative decarboxylation. This process is also catalyzed by the multi-enzyme complex ketoglutarate dehydrogenase, containing thiamine, pyrophosphate, lipoic acid, coenzyme A, FAD, and NAD. As a result, due to the second carbon atom that has entered the cycle, the second carbon dioxide molecule is released. At the same time, another NAD molecule is reduced to NADH and succinyl-CoA is formed. At the next stage, succinyl-CoA is cleaved into succinic acid, succinate, and the energy released in this case is accumulated in the ATP macroergic phosphate bond. This stage is important, since the released energy is directly accumulated in ATP. This type of ATP formation, similar to its formation during glycolysis, refers to substrate phosphorylation. The resulting succinic acid is oxidized to fumaric acid. The reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme succinate dehydrogenation, the proteinic group of which is FAD. At the same time, a third part of hydrogen is released, forming FADH2. In the next step, fumaric acid adding a water molecule is converted into malic acid using the enzyme fumarate dehydrogenase. At the last stage of the cycle, malic acid is oxidized to SCA. Glycolysis reaction occurs in the cytosol in chloroplast as a result of glycolysis. 2 pyruvic acid molecule and 4 ATP molecule are formed from 1 glucose molecule. In addition, during the glycolysis, 2 NAD molecules are reduced to NADH, the oxidation of which in the electron transport chain of mitochondria leads to the synthesis of 6 ATP molecules. A total of 8 ATP molecules are formed. The resulting 2 molecules of pyruvic acid enter the aerobic phase of respiration. When 1 molecule of pyruvic acid is oxidized, 3 NADH molecules and 1 NADPH molecule and 1 FADH2 molecule are formed, during oxidation of which 14 ATP molecules are synthesized in the respiratory electron transport chain. The energy balance of the breathing process. Summing up the energy of the respiration process, we calculate how many total ATP molecules can be formed when 1 glucose molecule breaks down. In the first anaerobic phase of respiration, when 1 glucose molecule breaks down to 2 pyruvic acid molecules, 2 ATP molecules accumulate during substrate phosphorylation. At the same time, during the phase of respiration, during the oxidation, 2 molecules are reduced. They diffuse through the outer membrane that are oxidized in the respiratory chain due to the presence of NADH in plant. In this case, 6 ATP molecules are synthesized. In the aerobic phase of respiration, during the oxidation of pyruvic acid, 2 molecules of NAD are formed. With photorespiration, energy casts are also associated, and the same is true of glycolytic pathway. The answer to this question is hardly complicated, and several ideas have been advanced. One view is the oxygenase function. It is suggested that photosynthesis led to accumulation of oxygen in the atmosphere, but high build-up of the oxygen was not accompanied by the loss of He functionally of the rubisca. On the other hand, infection due to photorespiration, if any, are not severe. Some workers believe that plants have turned photorespiration to its metabolic advantage. Thus, glycolate pathway act as a scavenger. For 2 turns of the cycle, 2 molecules of phosphoglycolate are formed by oxidation. Of the 4 carbon atoms, 1 is lost as carbon dioxide and 3 are returned to the chloroplast. Continued attempts are being made for the respiration through the use of chemical energy. Obviously, success in increasing photosynthesis are improving crop productivity has to be sought in other ways. Thus, a mechanism of concentration carbon dioxide in the photosynthesis cell could be a way to suppress photorespiration losses and improve the overall efficiency of carbon assimilation. Thus, PAD regenerates as before and can react with the next molecule. At the same time, during each cycle, 2 molecules are released into free NADH. As a result of decomposition of PVA molecule in the aerobic phase, those 5 pairs of NADH are formed from PVC and water enter the ATS.